In this tutorial, I'd like to demonstrate a technique that I call sketch chaining and demonstrate how that relates to a feature of SOLIDWORKS that's the shared sketch. And just to demonstrate what those two things are and how might be one might be better than the other in certain situations. So for this demo, we're just going to do a simple symbol, an extruded logo, which we can I'll just show the original image. So I'm going to start a sketch on the front plane, and I'm going to use my sketch picture tool to bring in the bitmap. And then what I would do is just in this sketch, I would trace out these main lines to get these regions. The strategy is going to be, you know, to draw the splines that compose the symbol. You can see these construction lines in here in the original drawing. And then to trim away the unwanted regions, to leave these three regions that are darkened here. And just for to save time, I've already done that, so I'm just going to unsuppress. I'm just going to unsuppress it. So I've already done that in this sketch. So you can see that I've just drawn a spline for all of the lines involved in this symbol, and then we can trim them away. We can trim away the segments that we don't need to get the intended shapes. So we could do this in the original sketch here using the trim tool, using the trim to closest mode. But we're going to run into problems when we start doing that. You know, this is fine. But what happens when I go up here? The interpolating spline will lose its relation when trim anyway. And that's one of the problems with trimming, because basically you're starting to break apart sketch entities that might have relations to one another, and then those relations have to go away. So I'm actually going to say no here, and let's back up a bit. I'm just going to undo. A better approach to something like this is actually to get out of your main sketch. So I've exited this sketch, and I'm going to start another sketch that's on the same plane. So again, I'm going to select my front plane and start a new sketch. Now I'm going to bring over my main lines from that first sketch. So I'm going to go and select it over here in the feature tree, and I'm going to use Convert Entities to basically import those lines over. Okay. Now my lines have been copied over from that first sketch, but the lines are, you could say that they're still safe in that first sketch. There's no way I can mess them up in this second sketch. Okay. So now I can use my trim tool and trim away the parts of these that I don't need. And when I do this, I'm actually going to turn off my automatic relations, because that might cause problems here. Okay, so again, I'm using the trim to closest trim mode here. So I'm just going to start getting rid of the parts that I don't need. This here. It's temporarily overdefined here, but we can sort that out later. Yeah. Get rid of this part, and I think that's everything. Even though I turned off automatic relations, it looks like it still added some relations that I don't want here. So I'm going to, I forgot this part. Okay, so I trimmed away all the parts of the original lines that I don't need, and it just leaves behind these three regions that I wanted to end up with. So this will become clear if I hide the first sketch. Now remember, I can't suppress it because sketch 6 depends on this main line sketch, but I can hide it to get it out of the way. Now this is what we have with our sketch 6 here, and it looks like I did forget to trim away one last part here. There we go. Okay. So this is what I wanted to end up with. Now this is better than having done all the trim in the main line sketch, because I've still got those relations the coincident relations and whatever, you know, if I had had parallel lines or offsets or whatever, those would still be preserved in the main lines sketch here, and everything is just imported into sketch 6, and then I was able to trim away what I didn't need. So I'm going to call this my regions. Okay, so let's say that what I want to do is extrude each of these out, but to a different height. So basically, I need to do 3 extrusion features, but they're all going to be based on this one sketch. Okay, there's 2 ways to approach this. The first is to just go ahead and let's do an extruded. Let's do an extrusion. I'm going to select this. Okay. Now I don't want to do all of them. Let's just say for some reason I have to do each of these separately. So I might use my selected contours tool here to say, okay, only do that one. And we're going to do that one up, you know, 10 millimeters. Okay. So I've got my first extrusion. Okay, that's fine. But now when I want to do the second and third ones, where's my sketch? Now, really, that sketch has been absorbed into this extrude one feature. I can get back at it to do additional extrusions based on this sketch. If I select it, it's calling itself a region now because I had only selected one region, but really that's my original sketch. I could select it and start another extrusion feature, and again go down to selected contours and say, okay, well, this time do this one, and let's do 20 millimeters. Okay. All right. So now you notice that this region sketch has this little hand under it, which means that it's being shared between these two features. And let's just go ahead and do the third one. So I would select it again. It doesn't matter which one. And I'm going to start another extrusion. Okay. And again, not feature scope, selected contours. I'm going to select only this one, and let's say this was going up 30. Okay. So now I've got 3 extrude features that all share the same sketch. And that's an okay way to go. But the problem with sharing sketches is it starts to make things very complicated in terms of your parent and child relationships. When a sketch is used in more than one feature, just the relationships between what is a precedent for what else starts to get kind of unwieldy, and you can get into trouble this way. So I'm going to show you an alternate way to accomplish this that doesn't use the idea of shared sketches. Okay, so let's delete these 2 extrusions. Actually, let's delete all 3. I'm going to delete these. Okay, so I'm back with my original region sketch. What I'm going to do instead is I'm going to chain off this sketch, and I'm going to make 3 individual sketches that have the part of the region sketch that I want. So again, I'm going to do another sketch on my front plane here. And I'm going to select my regions sketch and do convert entities. Okay, so I've got everything here. But now I'm just going to go and delete the parts that I didn't want at all. Okay. So let's call this sketch region 1. Okay. Now I'm going to do the same thing again, and I'm going to do it for this region and for this region. And instead of importing, let's start my sketch here. Instead of converting entities on the whole thing, I could just select. Remember, I'm holding down Control to do multiple select. Just select the part I want and do convert entities. That's a fine way to do it. So let's call this region 2. And let's do one more. Convert entities. Region 3. Okay. And I'm going to hide my original region sketch. So now what you're seeing here is 3 separate sketches. Now it's real easy. I can do an extrude on the first one. That's 10 millimeters. I'll do an extrude on the second one, up to 20 millimeters, and I'll do an extrude on the third one, 30 millimeters. Okay. Now, I don't have any shared sketches here. They're each their own sketch, but they're all related to this region's sketch through that convert entities. So, if I were to change something here, it would propagate down the chain to whichever of these regions that affected. Similarly, my main line sketch is still the base of this whole chain. So, if, for example, I was to edit this sketch, and let's just say I changed one of these. I don't know if I'm going to be able to drag this, actually. I have to get rid of that coincident relationship. And let's say I move this down here. Let's put that coincident relationship back. Now everything is updated. It may have been hard to see, but I had moved this line in the mainline sketch. That updated in my regions, and then region 2 was similarly updated. So everything is still depending on my mainline sketch, but the parent-child relationships are clearer now that I'm not using shared sketches here. So this is an approach that I'd recommend when you've got one main sketch. Usually that's going to be associated with some kind of a drawing that you've imported. Just use that to get your main lines down. But don't use that sketch as the basis for any features. Create chain sketches off of that main sketch and use those for the features. That's going to make your life a whole lot simpler in terms of maintaining your parent-child relationships in your part.